First of all, introduce to us, who's here with us today?
Ruben Villa.
You sparred Haney?
Yeah.
What was that like? Wait, first of all, what weight class do you fight at?
126.
Okay, and he's obviously walks around 165,
yeah,
we know that.
For sure.
So how was that?
It was good.
I'm not lying.
Big as hell, but it was good work for me. I mean, I got what I wanted out of it. He was getting ready for Loma, so, I mean, I got what I
thought Loma beat him.
Yeah, me too, bro. I did too.
I thought Loma beat Haney. I'm just saying. So you fight at 126. Yeah. What do you think about Gervonta Davis and Frank Martin?
It's a good fight. Take it, though.
Why?
He's a beast.
What about Ryan and the guy you sparred, Devin Haney?
Shit, I really don't even know. Because Ryan's going through what he's going through right now.
He might not make it to fight night.
Yeah, we don't know.
Is there a line if it makes it to the fight or not?
There should be, but I don't know. But you're good in bets, and you're good in playing poker, so I don't know.
I would bet it to go.
Why?
It seems like Ryan's got his shit together.
It's only 40 days. He hasn't. I think he's only started going to the gym. He's been training on his own.
Are you ready for Ryan Hart? Like super bad?
No, I just hope he does well. I want to see him healthy. I don't want him going into the fight if he's only 10% of himself.
Yeah.
Or 15%.
Yeah.
This is a very dangerous sport, and you have to be close to 100. Nobody's going to ever be 100%. What's your record now?
21-1.
Okay, if you had your first 17 fights in TJ, what would be your record? Exactly. When you sparred him, how hard did he hit?
Not very hard. He had 25 pounds on me, at least 30 pounds on me.
He beat Devin Haney in the amateurs.
You fought him in amateurs?
Mm-hmm.
How did you beat him?
At the JLs.
No, but I'm saying, was it the jab? Was it the speed? The power?
He was just running, to be honest. He was just...
Well, he still has the same style today, pretty much.
Yeah, he's a little bit more, aggressive now, you would say, but...
Hey, Virgil, he beat Haney in the amateurs.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
He even beat Shakur, I think.
Yeah.
Shakur, and, okay. Shakur against Devin, who wins?
Shakur.
Fuck, Shakur.
Why?
He's way better.
What makes you say, what aspect? Like, explain.
He has a better jab, he has better feet, probably has a little bit more power.
How?
More educated.
Ruben, a lot of people tell me Shakur will never lose. How did you have success against him in amateurs?
Being aggressive, being on him the full three rounds. Every time, the two times that I beat him, I was on him. Even the times I lost, it was pretty close, but he got me. But just being aggressive and just being
okay.
On him.
You have a spar tank?
No.
But you sparred, you fought and you sparred Devin.
Yeah.
If Tank fights Devin, what happens? Tank? Yeah. Easy or hard?
I wouldn't say hard, but... I don't know, I think Tank is just better at setting it up. He'll give a couple rounds to catch that one good shot and most likely knock you out.
It's like Tank and Shakur and then everybody else.
That's how you see it.
I mean,
okay.
I mean, Teofimo is super athletic too. Teofimo is dynamic, okay. You know what I mean?
Ryan was live yesterday and he said he would love to fight Tank at 140.
Yeah.
Or Teofimo. Or Loma. Or Manny Pacquiao. That would be his dream fight. How does Ryan do in those four fights?
Okay, say it again.
I don't know.
Tank rematch at 40.
Okay.
Who wins?
Tank.
Why?
He's just better. Like, he makes less mistakes. The reason why he'll lose is because the mistakes he makes. If he covers up the mistakes and like continues to get better, obviously he has a way better chance of winning. Yeah.
What do you think?
I agree.
Okay. How about?
It's like Ryan has really good intangibles. You know. It's like super
speed,
fast,
power. Yeah.
Length. Strength, you know, all those things.
Like, I just need him to be 100%.
Like, this dude's okay. A beast, you know? But he just makes, I think people criticize him because he makes just like fundamental mistakes, maybe.
Okay, what about Ryan and Pacquiao?
Now.
He can win that fight.
Yeah, I think he might be able to win that fight.
Okay, what about him and Teo?
Teo's better. I feel like Teo's more dedicated and just more that lifestyle where it seems like Ryan has a lot of distractions, but... Shit, you never know what deal you're gonna get either. So
okay, him and Loma, you sparred Loma, right?
No, I never sparred Loma.
I thought you did for some reason. You were supposed to?
Nah. Okay. Never sparred Loma.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a good one too. But I think Loma will get him with his
feet. Okay. You got Loma. How about Canelo against Munguia?
Canelo.
Why?
He's more fundamentally sound. And he'll just box him, you know.
Okay.
I think. We'll see.
Benavides, Canelo?
That's hard.
Benavides.
I think Benavides.
His aggression.
Okay.
Strength.
Pita, the other day we watched two 26-pounders going at it, and you were very disappointed at the fight. It was Ray Vargas against some guy named what's his name? Nick Ball?
Yeah.
Would you like
the winner of that?
You want to fight them on the same night, both of them?
Yeah.
How would he do?
The first six rounds.
How would he do against did Nick Ball?
I've never seen him fight Evan.
Nick Ball promoter said he got robbed. What fight was he watching?
Nick Ball?
That's what his promoter. Frank Warren said my fighter got robbed.
They counted one of the.
No, it was a draw.
That wasn't a
I know, but he did win. He won the last six rounds and he had two knockdowns.
Take off that knockdown. They didn't. He pushed him. That was a football knockdown.
That's the first six rounds he did.
That was like the worst case scenario for us because if there's a clear cut winner, like we're next in line, you know?
I know.
So it's like now there's controversy. Yeah, I'm hoping Nick Ball fights Ray Ford in that 5-on-5.
How about you and Vargas?
Nick Ball said he's going to fight fucking.
Ray.
Raven Ford?
Yeah.
Who wins that one? Ray Ford, easy, huh? So you want to fight who, Ray?
First six rounds, I think, were hard for Nick Ball because how tall
Ray
Vargas was. Raymond Ford, you know what I mean?
Ray Ball?
Yeah, he's going to make it a good fight.
He look, you know what he looked like? He looked like, you know, Wish.com or one of those, Timu, whatever those were. Pitbull Cruise from one of those fake websites. That's what he looked like.
The wrecking ball.
He didn't wreck nothing.
No?
No.
You didn't like that. You didn't like that one.
Pita, is he the wrecking ball or does he need a new nickname? Nick Ball. Air Ball. Air Ball. I'm sure he's tough.
Probably hit hard, but
that was an ugly style. Ray Vargas is ugly as fucking style.
Yeah, dude. So, and he has no shame in fucking.
Okay, who has uglier style? Miguel Vasquez or Ray Vargas?
Click number two twice.
Miguel Vasquez with the goatee back in the day. With the southpaw.
Oh, yeah.
And it's start.
Yeah, that dude. Yeah. Wow.
All right, so Dracula, who you want to call out? Give me three names.
I didn't start. Now though, my last fight.
Okay. You fought him already?
Yeah, I beat him.
Okay.
It's weird because I'm calling him out and I beat
him.
He has a belt, so obviously that's what I'm going for. So it doesn't look like we're going to get that, so we're going to hit the WBC route. This fight will be for the silver title. And then
all right, let's do it. You got it. Tell me where to follow you.
RB4 Ruben Villa on Instagram and Twitter.
At Sam Garcia Boxing.
Make sure to follow him. Stay tuned. Are you still doing poker?
We opened the gym. Like over the last couple years. Yeah. So it's good.
All right, there you have it. Batman Dracula.
Yeah,
stay tuned. Ellie said back. Reporting. Boots Ennis against Devin Haney. What do you think?
Boots is badass, yeah, Boots is different.
Why?
Are you talking Boots and Crawford? Then you're talking.
Well, I love that fight, but I think Crawford's going to fight Chris Eubanks Jr.
Yeah.
Which is only big in England or the Middle East. I don't think in the U.S.
Like is it going to be over there? Why can't it be over here?
Name for me four people that Chris Eubanks Jr. fought. Hold on.
I don't
know. Hold on.
Am I tripping?
Big Louie, really quick. Name for me four people that Chris Eubanks Jr. fought.
Chris Eubanks what?
Fought. Name me two people.
I don't even follow him.
Pita, four people that Chris Eubanks fought.
Four people that what?
Chris Eubanks fought.
You're supposed to fight Conor Benn.
Oh no, besides the one.
Smith, he lost.
Yeah, that's all he did, I know.
Okay.
Then he avenged it, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
That's all you need nowadays, bro.
I don't know.
One good place.
Nobody knows. So you ask me. No, they ask me. If,
right, look, that's over there.
It's a big money fight for Crawford. Go do it. But
don't really watch or pay attention to
results. No. The five against five, we don't know who they are.
5-on-5. I hope it's Nick Ball versus Ray Ford.
Okay.
Raymond Ford.
How old is Ngannou?
How old is Ngannou? Right, like in his 30s now?
No, no. How old do you think he is?
How old do I think he is? I'm just taking a guess. I don't know, like 34 or 33.
30?
I have no idea. I didn't.
They say he's 35. I thought he's like 45.
Oh, really?
I don't know. Just observing.
Damn.
We had a Colombian kid that said he was 20. What is he? He was 23.
And he was?
I still don't know.
I thought he was like more my age. Like it was like, forward, like in his 40s.
So did you sign him? Did you promote him? Did you push
him? Yeah, we fought a bunch of times with him.
He was only 23.
Ruben Severa, he's probably watching this right now. Talk shit to him. I have another friend who watches all your shit, but he's a hater. His name's Chino. Chino Rodriguez. So
shout out Chino.
In the video, he's like, Ellie, dude, he's so stupid. I'm like, he watches every single one of your videos.
It's okay.
He texts me talking shit. I said, that's my friend.
Thanks for watching.
Yeah.
Why is his name Chino?
Because he's Mexican, but he has like Chino looking eyes and a big round face. Huh? So next time you see him, I'll introduce him to you. And he's
let's do it. Nah, it's...
Yeah, Colombia. He's still over there. He got stuck with the visa.
Pete, he was like 43. He said he was 23. True story.
Yeah, he always talks shit about money. I don't know.
Yeah,
yeah, he's strong.
You, they always say that in the Dominicans in baseball, I'm 12, but really he's like 28.
He won like a, I don't know, he probably won like 5 or 6 fights in a row. Recently.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And now he's stuck back home?
We're hoping that to get his visa stuff together and then top rank and he can get a big fight with somebody. So now he has like 19 wins.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Good luck on your next fight. Hopefully it happens. Stay tuned. Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.